Protein is extremely important when it comes to weight loss, but also just overall health, because we do need to have it every single day. And if you aren't sure that you're getting enough protein, there's some fairly obvious signs that you can keep an eye out for. I'm sharing 5 signs that you need to boost your protein intake so that you can actually achieve your wellness goals in today's video. All right, guys, if you're new to my channel and you don't know who I am, my name's Autumn and I'm a certified clinical nutritionist with my master's in nutrition human performance. On my channel, I'm typically talking about the science-backed and holistic methods that you can use in order to achieve your wellness dreams. So if you have a wellness goal in mind, make sure you subscribe. Okay, so we talk a lot about the importance of eating until satiated in order to achieve your weight loss and your wellness goals, as well as the food components that are needed in order to feel satisfied. So if you're not familiar with that term satiated, or if you're new to my channel, satiated just means that you feel satisfied, you don't feel hungry, but you also don't feel overly stuffed. And there's 3 major components that are really important for feeling satiated or satisfied, and those include protein, fat, and fiber. However, the most important aspects when it comes to long-term satiety are protein and fat. Both of those macronutrients stimulate different hormones within the body, one called peptide YY, one called cholecystokinin or CCK, which tells your brain that you're full and you don't need to eat for around 4 to 5 hours. And typically on my channel, we focus a lot on the fat component because that's what's been demonized for a long time. So I've been trying to bring to light how important those fats really are for achieving your weight loss or your wellness goals. But today I wanted to dive into the component we don't talk as much about, and that's the protein component. Protein is one macronutrient that we don't really significantly store. Yes, we do use it to build our muscles, but we don't want to tap into that in order to use amino acids. If you're tearing down your muscles in order to create hormones or new cells, then that's really just a state of starvation, and that's what we want to avoid. Which means in order to feel satiated, in order to achieve those weight loss goals, as well as in order to maintain our muscle mass, it's essential that we get enough protein in every day. Because here's the thing, our body is constantly tearing itself down so that it can rebuild itself new and better. I mean, your skin and your gut lining are constantly tearing itself down so that it can make way for these new skin cells and the new gut lining. Your red blood cells are recycled and new ones are formed so that you can make sure you have healthy blood supply. Even your hormones are constantly being remade as well so that your body can continue to do its job and continue to work at its best. And what's the main driver of all of this creation and recreation? Protein and amino acids. Protein really is the key building block of pretty much every single aspect in our body. And this is why not having enough protein can wreak so much havoc on the entire body, because it has its hand in everything. When you don't have enough protein, you're essentially just diminishing the supplies that your body has to pull from in order to continue to recreate itself. So that means perhaps your hormones are suffering, or maybe you're not able to rebuild more muscle, or perhaps even your hair is falling out. All of these are important aspects that protein has a hand in. With this in mind, let's dive into those 5 examples of when you might want to consider increasing your protein intake. Now, the first, you break out. Protein deficiency has long been linked to skin concerns, especially a low protein breakfast or breakfast. This is why it's especially important to make sure that you are including high quality and bioavailable sources of protein at each of your meals, especially if you're prone to experiencing breakouts or acne. In fact, this is actually something I even noticed with myself and of course a lot of my clients, but there's a time in college when you maybe don't have as much money, like I didn't have very much money in college. As a result, I was decreasing the amount of protein I was eating purely to save money. And that was the first time I really started to experience a lot of breakouts. And I accidentally continued this lower protein intake for quite a while, even after college, and noticed that breakouts just continued to persist. But as soon as I reintroduced a higher amount of protein, not high protein, but just really making sure my body is getting what it needed, my breakouts significantly decreased. Now, especially because it is really important to start your first meal off, whether you are using fasting or you're not, with some type of protein. There's a couple ways that you can add it in if you notice that you are really having a low protein intake at your first meal. One is with 1 cup of grass-fed whole milk Greek yogurt. That's going to contain a pretty significant amount of protein just right there. Or you could incorporate egg scrambles for your first meal, and that in itself is also a highly bioavailable source of protein that you can just make sure you're getting with your first meal. All right, the second, you have slow muscle recovery. This is probably the one that most of us think of when we think of lack of protein intake, is our muscle suffering. And yes, it is one of the most obvious ones because it's the one that we attribute protein to. Typically, when you think protein, you think muscle mass. Because here's the thing, when you're working out, you are breaking down your muscles. And this is an important part of the workout so that your body can then stimulate itself to then repair those muscles and make it stronger than it was before. But if after workout, that stimulus is going and you don't have enough amino acids to actually then reform the muscle, it's just being constantly broken down without being reformed, which means that your muscle recovery is going to be a lot slower because you just don't have the tools in order to repair them. So how can you possibly expect expect muscle recovery to happen if you don't even have those tools in order to repair your muscles. And the way that you can tell if you're experiencing really slow muscle recovery is if you just feel generally weak after a workout, especially if it's a day or a couple days after workout, if your muscles feel excessively sore all the time, even if you're not new to a workout routine and you've been working out for a while, but you still feel like you're not gaining strength, those are really big signs that you are not getting enough protein. Number three, you're really hungry. As I discussed earlier, and something I dive into in the Complete Intermittent Fasting Bundle protocols, is the importance of protein for satiety. Remember, satiety is that sensation of feeling full or satisfied, and it's really important, especially if you're looking for a weight loss goal. Because some of the worst things you can do when you're looking to achieve a weight loss goal is snack. Snacking causes that constantly raised insulin level throughout the day, especially if you're eating every couple of hours, and insulin is our storing hormone. So the more often that's raised, the more often that lipolysis or fat burning is turned off, and the less likely you are to actually tap into fat burning and achieve your weight loss goal. So we really wanna make sure that we can get those gaps between meals, whether it's using intermittent fasting or using a 3 or 2 meal structure. And the only way to do that is to make sure that you achieve that hormonal response of satiety with protein and fat specifically, as well as a little bit with fiber, but the most important aspects there are protein and fat for the long-term satiety. And protein stimulates that hormonal response of satiety with peptide YY when you eat it, but we need to make sure that you're getting enough for your body's needs. Otherwise, your body's going to sense that it still is hungry because it still needs those supplies that are crucial for every mechanism within your body. And if you don't stimulate that peptide YY or CCK by not getting enough protein or fat for that matter, then no matter how much you eat, you could eat a very large meal that's stuffed with vegetables, really fills your stomach, but if you aren't satisfying that hormonal response of satiety, then you're still going to feel that sensation to eat, even if you are physically feeling stuffed, because you did not get enough of the protein and fat for that matter, but we're really focusing on protein here today. And one of the really huge signs that you're not getting enough protein when you're hungry is if you feel hungry within 2 hours. Because remember, both protein and fat help to provide that satiety for about 4 to 5 hours after your meal with the hormonal response of satiety. So if you're not getting enough of either of those, then that's where you'll feel hungry before that 4 to 5 hour mark. Number four, your hair is thinning. Hair is one of the most obvious visuals of how your body is constantly creating new cells to replace those old ones. And without adequate protein, then you don't have enough of those proteins or the amino acids in order to create new hair cells. This can result in thinning hair as you shed your old hair, but there's less available to make new hair to replace it. And this is something I personally experienced in high school, which I don't believe I've shared this story before, but when I was in high school, I was exposed to black mold, and as a result, I got really, really sick. I had a high fever of 104 degrees for multiple days, and I couldn't eat. It wasn't even nausea, I just couldn't really eat anything. Which of course, when you're not eating anything, that means you're also not eating protein either. I was already a really active and lean kid at that age. I played a lot of different sports. I didn't really have weight to lose, but during this whole process of not being able to eat for 3 weeks, I lost 20 pounds, which on my frame is a lot of weight. And I experienced these classic signs of what I'm explaining with the decreased protein intake. I was so weak, I experienced such intense muscle weakness that I couldn't even walk by myself from one room to the other during this time. I mean, not to mention my body was spending so much energy trying to repair itself just from being exposed to this black mold that I didn't really have much energy left for anything else. And about a month or so later, I was actually able to start eating again. And it did take me a little bit of time just because my GI tract wasn't used to eating. So it did take some time for me to actually start eating normal amounts of food and normal amounts of protein again. But about a month and a half later is when I really started to see the rebounding effects of not having enough protein, specifically with my hair. I was losing my hair at a really, really alarming rate. It was really scary, especially being in high school when you're already under the pressures of the peers around you. I was losing hair so quickly, I would brush my hair and clumps would come out. It was extremely frightening, especially at that age. And this constant losing of hair went on for a couple weeks until I'd lost probably about 3/4 of my hair. I naturally have pretty thick hair as well, so it was also very dramatic hair loss experience. And because of course hair takes time to grow, it took a little over a year for me to finally get my hair back to normal. And that was just from 3 weeks of being sick and not being able to eat protein. And you can imagine being in high school at the time, I was in 9th grade, early high school. It was really rough emotionally and physically on me. Obviously, this is a much more extreme experience of not having enough protein. This was 3 full weeks of not only not having enough protein, but also being sick and having more protein requirements because of that. that, but it just goes to show how important protein is and how if you don't have enough for your body's needs, then you can experience symptoms like hair loss, even if it is at a much lower or slower degree. Perhaps you're not experiencing the big clumps like I was experiencing, but you just notice more shedding, your hair is thinning. Those are all common signs of protein deficiency or not having enough protein in your diet. And number five, again, not a surprise, especially from the story I just shared, but you feel weak or fatigued. Now, of course, with slower muscle recovery, your muscles aren't able to perform at its peak, so you're going to feel more fatigued or just weak in general. Like I mentioned, this is exactly what I experienced when I wasn't able to eat for 3 weeks and I was very, very low in energy as a result. And this can translate to feeling more weak or fatigued throughout the day. You may have experienced this even in a more acute manner in a shorter amount of time if perhaps you did a really hard workout and throughout that day you didn't get enough protein to satisfy your needs. And so the next day you just feel a little bit more weak and lethargic and tired. Now for bioavailability purposes, when it comes to protein, whole food sources of protein will generally be your best bet, but if you do need to help boost your protein intake, protein powders are another option that you can utilize. Now, if you are trying to figure out exactly how much protein you really should be taking in, I dived deep into how to calculate this with this video right here. It's in tip number 4, so you can fast forward to that point in order to check it out. Also, if you're new to my channel and you love the science-backed information on how you can achieve your wellness dreams, make sure you subscribe right here. Come out with new videos every Tuesday and Thursday. All right, guys, thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll see you in my next video.